Take the Time to Care from TV8.
Today, from high above the beach in Santa Monica, California, the mysterious death of a TV Superman, the crazed quest of a super maniac, and a sexy scandal involving some super women. It was portrayed as fantasy in the movies.
An army which carries the Ark before it. He's invincible.
But now it can be told. Hitler really was obsessed with getting his hands on a fabled religious relic.
Hitler came and saw this lance, and he fell in love with it.
It's called the Spear of Destiny, the Holy Lance. According to legend, the weapon that pierced the side of Jesus.
He imagined this lance to be God's proof that the Germans had a role to play in the history of mankind.
It's almost unbelievable, but it's true, and now it can be told. Hitler and the Holy Spear.
Just wasting your ammunition, Blinky.
Who killed the Man of Steel? Was it suicide or murder? We'll show you three scenarios for the death of George Reeves and present sensational evidence of what may have been a fatal love triangle.
Tony may very well have enlisted the help of her husband to resolve this situation.
What really happened that night in the bedroom? It's Murder Mystery Thursday, and you'll be the judge and jury as we ask, who shot Superman? Welcome, everybody. I'm Geraldo Rivera, and waiting down there on the beach here in Santa Monica are some beauties who are run out of another California town in a controversial storm of a bikini contest. I'll be speaking with them and telling you all about their run-in with the authorities later in the program. But up front today, the Spear of Destiny. Okay, now let's go on to another intriguing story. This one, a murder mystery involving Superman. Who killed actor George Reeves? Was it suicide? Was it the mob? Or was it a jealous girlfriend? You'll be the judge and jury when we return in a moment with Murder Mystery Thursday. And later, the strange saga of a banned bikini contest. Welcome back. The year was 1959 and the headlines came as a shock to us. Superman was dead. The actor George Reeves had apparently committed suicide. And the lethal weapon wasn't kryptonite. It was a speeding bullet.
Look, up in the sky. It's a bird.
It's a plane.
It's Superman.
For millions of kids growing up in the 1950s, Superman epitomized the ultimate hero. From 1951 through 1957, actor George Reeves faithfully donned leotards and cape to become the man who was faster than a speeding bullet.
Just wasting your ammunition, Blinky.
Taken from the comic strip, Superman quickly became the hottest TV series of its time. Today, it ranks behind I Love Lucy as the second longest running show in syndication. The role brought Reeves fame and fortune. He seemed to easily fit into the character. On his own, Reeves would make school and charity appearances to spread the gospel of Superman. Truth,
justice, and the American way.
But it also typecast him so strongly that few studios would ever cast him in any other part. Except for his earlier small role in Gone with the Wind, his later film career consisted mainly of B-movies. In 1958, the show took a one-year hiatus after 104 episodes. It was due to go back into production in 1959, and Reeves was to make an additional 26 shows. He was 45 years old and engaged to marry Lenore Lemon, a New York party girl. But there was another woman on the scene, Toni Mannix, who was heartbroken by Reeves' marriage plans. Married to Eddie Mannix, a big studio executive at MGM, Reeves and Toni had been having an affair for years, with Eddie's blessings.
Toni Mannix was a very jealous woman, and the affair breaking up the way it did and involving another woman the way it did upset her enormously.
Then on June 16th, 1959, it all ended. George Reeves shot himself. Unlike Superman, he proved a mere mortal. The police ruled his death suicide. Friends said he was depressed over work, but others insist it was murder. Who could have killed the Man of Steel? Was it the jilted Toni Mannix or her husband Eddie? Or could it have been Lenore? So was it foul play? We'll look at those suspects later. But first, some experts who claim it was indeed a suicide.
I believe, in my heart, and through the investigations I've conducted with people and weighing all the evidence, that George Reeves did indeed kill himself.
Paul Mandel, a freelance writer and Superman expert, believes George Reeves was depressed enough about his own career to do himself in.
He was depressed, extremely depressed about it. He no longer looked like Superman. He had changed physically. He was 45 years old. The role of Superman did typecast him. He could not get any other work.
In addition, Mandel says Reeves was not entirely happy with his fiancée, Lenore Lemon.
She was kind of a wild party girl. And George was not happy about that. Lenore treated George very callously. And that depressed George to no end.
This is the official police version of Reeves' death on June 16, 1959. It's told in part by another Superman enthusiast, the author Chuck Harder.
George Reeves, Lenore Lemon, and a friend of theirs named Robert Condon were all in the house. They spent the evening drinking and hanging out. George apparently went to bed around midnight. Around 1, Mrs. Carol Van Ronkel and a gentleman named William Bliss showed up at the front door and wanted to come in and party. They came in and started being loud. It woke him up. He came downstairs and apparently was very upset at being woken up. He argued with William Bliss for a while, it's not known how long, and then had a drink with him and made up, and suddenly looked depressed and started going upstairs.
George Reeves was known to have a gun collection, but friends say it was used only to frighten intruders. According to the police, George opened his drawer and took out the Luger pistol. A shot rang out. William Bliss ran upstairs and found George dead with a bullet through his head. 40 minutes later, the police were finally called. The police wrote Reeves' death off as a suicide.
He was a larger-than-life figure, and I think because he was a larger-than-life figure, that's one of the problems that many people have believing that he committed suicide.
Toward the end of his life, George Reeves had lots of plans, a major publicity tour, the resumption of his series, his own production company, not the kinds of things you would ordinarily associate with a man contemplating suicide. Indeed, one of the people who has the most trouble accepting the ruling of suicide is one of Reeves' best friends. And we'll be speaking with him as our investigation continues.
They could have snuck in through the bedroom window.
Toni Mannix was a very jealous woman.
Lenore Lemon killed George Reeves. That is a fact.
There was immediate skepticism surrounding the death of George Reeves. His own mom, for example, hired a private investigator who reportedly found 2 extra bullet holes in his bedroom. And then there was this close friend who wouldn't buy the conclusion of suicide.
I was told that his death was suicide by self-inflicted gunshot wound, and I said I didn't believe it. And I went to the mortuary the next morning and saw the wound and saw my friend.
Art Weissman emphatically discounts suicide. He believes it could have been an accident.
He was not a believer in live ammunition in those guns in the house because there had been parties in the house before, and he didn't like the idea of anybody picking up a gun and saying bang. And so the fact that there was live ammunition in one of the guns is a problem for me to accept.
Weissman also believes Reeves' death could have been made to look like an accident.
An accidental shooting might have been somebody loading the guns without his knowledge.
However, powder burns were never found on Reeves, which shows that the gun was never held close to his head. That means someone else could have fired it. Weissman points the finger at Eddie Mannix, husband of the woman with whom Reeves was having an affair.
Eddie Mannix looked to me like a man who might have participated in some kind of an arrangement. He may very well have enlisted the help of her husband to resolve this situation.
Chuck Harder has other suspects in mind. He claims Reeves had big gambling debts that were owed to gangsters.
They could have been in the house. They could have snuck in through the bedroom window. Remember, George Reeves had pretty much an open house. There were a lot of people in there all the time, and friends of friends.
Harder criticized the police for their lackadaisical investigation. They over